I've got here a variety of boats for you to see the differences between one rowing boat and another. No boat can do everything, just like no car can do everything. This boat is a lot wider and shorter than this boat, which is very long and thin. So this is like your Grand Prix racing car. It's a racing boat, it's my racing boat, and it's very, very slim, very unstable, difficult to learn, impossible to learn to scull in. It's impossible even to sit in this boat on the water without oars. Now, a boat like the Yole here, you could stand up in this boat, turn round, turn sand on your head without oars in it at all. So this is a stable boat, okay? The turbos have an advantage, which I'll explain to you. You can stand in the bottom of the boat when you get in and out. Why is that important? Well, it affects how stable it feels. This is below the waterline, so when you get in, it feels stable. You're standing underneath the point around which it tips. That's not the case with a racing boat. Let me show you. In a racing boat, you never stand on the hull and the bottom of the boat because it's too fragile. And you have to stand here. And this is above the tipping point. So as soon as you stand in a racing boat, it feels really scary and you get white knuckle syndrome. So this is not the way to learn. All the boats here have got outriggers. Okay, and this is so that we can make the boat slimmer, and that makes it faster than if you had to have the boat as wide as this. The distance between the gates is the same on all of the boats. Here the outrigger is attached by nuts and bolts. Here the outrigger on this boat is just attached by clips, which are very quick to use. And this outrigger, this is a very interesting boat, slides forwards and backwards. All the boats have got sliding gear, some means of sliding forwards and backwards so that you can bend your legs and use your whole body to get more power out of your body. And all the boats have got something for you to press your feet against. This is called a stretcher. All of these boats are unsinkable. That's to say, they're full of air and you could throw as much water over them as you like and they won't sink because they have built-in buoyancy. This whole space here is sealed and no air can get in or out of that, and no water can get in or out. This is the same, but you can see it's a lot bigger, wider, more volume. Well, what's the difference? Well, if you were to row this through a wave that was only this high, then this boat, the cockpit would fill with water and you'd have wet feet. And this boat would just simply ride over the top of it. The same with this one here. This turbo skiff has a decent volume and will cope well with waves in a harbour from a big launch wash or a ferry going by or something like that. Whereas this one, again, it's slim like a racing boat, and on rough water you'll find water rolling in here. It still won't sink. You could go over this with an outboard motor and shred it to pieces and all the pieces would float because of the way it's made. But you'd get wet inside the cockpit. The wider boats have got runners underneath and or keel and a skeg at the end. Whereas this one has virtually nothing to keep it straight but a tiny little fin here. This turbo skiff has a flat bottom to keep it stable, and as opposed to the separate riggers of the Yole or the racing boat, these boats both have what we call a wing rigger. And this rigger on the turbo skiff slides forwards and backwards. So you would sit here, and when you're bending your legs, instead of going towards the boat or towards the rigger comes toward you. This means that your mass, your weight, stays still in the middle of the boat. You're not moving forwards and backwards all the time. And that reduces the amount of drag, which is what makes the boat go so fast. And it's very, very easy to remove. You just undo these two butterfly nuts here, lift the riggers up, and off it comes, very quick. This rigger, it's very clever insofar as it's made out of one big curved piece of aluminium, so there's no focal point for the stress, and it's very light. Quite amazing when you see the bulk of it. It looks as though it's going to be heavy, but it's not heavy. And these clips enable you to remove the rigger quickly and easily. And the floats here, again, just a couple of bolts to remove those, and you have yourself a boat that's nearly a racing boat. It's not quite as narrow and not quite as long as a racing boat. And this has, instead of a sliding rigger, a sliding seat. Okay. And again, if we look at this stretcher, you put your feet in there without any shoes on. In a racing boat, we put our feet in, again, without any shoes on, because the shoes are already in the boat. They're already attached to the boat. They're part of the boat. These flexible shoes came in the 1970s when slides started to get longer and longer and longer, till the point where people's heels were lifting out of the heel traps, and this meant that your feet would fall out of the shoes. So that was no good. So flexible shoes got around that problem. This boat, we call it a yawl. You can use it as a single or a double. At the moment it's rigged as a double, but it takes a jiffy to change it to a single. That's it, rigged as a single. You move the stretcher to here, and then it's a single. Or you can take a passenger with you, so you can use this as a real family boat. Really, to understand why this boat is suitable for use on the sea, and it's self-bailing, water that comes in goes straight back out, you need to understand that the water line is here, and it comes right to the tip of the boat here, and there's a gap between the water line, about that much, and the open aft. What you can also see on the yawl is that it's made of two hulls, really, an inner hull and an outer hull. This is how lifeboats are made. So there is a lot of air trapped inside this space. So that's what keeps it afloat and makes it feel, it feels like a cork. When you're rowing on a rough sea, it just goes up and down with the waves, rides over the waves really easily. And any water that gets over the bows, if you do get water over the bows, then it just runs straight down here and out of the boat, so it never fills up with water. You can use a yawl upriver on nice calm water, but you can also row it in the Atlantic, and I've done this. You can row, people have rowed across the channel in this boat. Somebody has even rowed around Iceland in one of these. Okay, just a brief word about materials. You can have boats like this turbo skiff made out of fiberglass and polyester, or you can have it made out of polyethylene like this. Polyethylene is very tough and resilient, and you could drop it and it would bounce. This actually is a section through a yawl, and you can have a yawl made out of polyethylene also. Polyethylene is an industrial material. It's the same thing that you make washing up bowls from. If you were using a yawl as a working boat, then you would want to have it as polyethylene. If you want to go fishing and leave your boat on the beach, then polyethylene is a good material to choose. But it's heavier. The difference between a yawl in fiberglass and a yawl in polyethylene is about 30 pounds. But it's cheaper because it's made in an industrial process. Fiberglass, because it's a handmade product, it's more expensive, but it does look a lot nicer, and it is lighter and therefore faster. If you're going to use the boat in a club or a school where it's going to get a lot of abuse, then a polyethylene boat is a good idea. If you want to take your daughter or your granddaughter or your brother or wife out rowing, then you need a boat that is capable of taking two people, like the yawl here. And if you want to row in the sea, you definitely need a boat like this. And if you want to progress to a racing boat, then it's a good idea to have a boat where you can go from having stabilizers when you learn to taking them off, so you're nearly here, and then you can progress to a racing boat. So that's a great boat for use in schools and clubs to teach people to scull. So there you have it. No one boat will do everything.